Today, we're gonna be going over fillers, protein fillers, and color fillers. This is a really short portion of your book. It's on page 626, and I'm using the red Milady book. We're gonna cover the main points in your book, which is not much because it's so short, but then we're gonna go in more depth of fillers because they're extremely important, especially if you're going blonde to brown or darker. If you don't use a filler, you're going to get muddy or green hair. So we're gonna cover this a little bit more, and then I'm gonna demo it hair color with a filler and hair color without a filler so you can compare. But if you're looking for more, I just need the information to pass my test. Those key points are going to be in the description box because I get it. So when you're doing a filler, it can either be conditioner or color. So conditioner or protein fillers are using a protein-based product to fill in the gaps of the hair. So pretend this is a hair strand, a single piece of hair, and this is a very healthy strand of hair. It's nice and smooth. Now this is an overly porous piece of hair. So it looks a little bit like Swiss cheese. It has a bunch of holes and dents in it. When you're coloring hair, you obviously want to start with the best canvas you can, which is a healthy strand of hair or healthy head of hair. So we can take a protein or conditioner filler and put it over this hair shaft, and it's going to go in and fill in these gaps. It doesn't restore the hair. Once hair is damaged, the best way to restore it is to cut it off and start over. It's making a temporary fix by filling in the potholes. So it is kind of like when they fill in potholes on the road. They fill it in, but eventually there's gonna be another pothole there because it's not the original clean, smooth surface or road like this. An example of a protein filler is this. It's just protein that's going in and filling in the gaps. So this gives you a cleaner canvas to work on, making the hair color results way more predictable. An example of when to use a protein filler is when you're doing more milder or lighter hair colors, like a toner. So this is not going to be when you're going from blonde to brown. If you're here and want to be here, you need a color filler, and we'll go over that in a few minutes. My favorite toner I've been using lately is 8VB. That helps cancel out the orange and yellow tones that show up in my hair, but I can't just apply this root to ends. About the mid shaft to the ends of my hair are very porous, which is a nice way to say they're a little bit damaged. They've got a lot of these potholes. I need to even out the porosity with a conditioning filler before I put the toner over it. If I don't do that and just apply the toner all over, root to ends, without doing any kind of pre-treatment, the top of my head is gonna look nice, but the bottom is gonna grab on to those tones. The tones are violet and blue. So the ends, because they're porous, they're like a kitchen sponge with those large holes that's gonna soak up all the product. It's going to look murky, dark, have a little bit of violet, blue, gray, or even ashy, while the top of my hair looks fine. And you'll see that a lot with people who use the violet-based shampoos or blue-based shampoos. The top of their hair is fine, but the ends are purple because the ends are very porous, especially on blondes. So when you go through and put the toner or do the purple shampoo without any kind of pre-treatment, without the protein filler, you're getting purple shampoo toner in here, filling in the gaps. And it's gonna make this part appear darker. So to avoid that, before you do a toner, purple shampoo, whatever you're doing, you're gonna put a protein or conditioner filler on top first. So before I tone my hair, this goes on any porous parts, which is, again, all of the ends, they're fried. So your protein fillers, or your book says conditioner fillers, just even out the porosity when you're doing light changes. Toning, violet-based shampoos, anything that's not a drastic change. A color filler is something you use when you have lighter hair and you're going to take it darker, and you're using an actual hair color. When we lighten hair, we remove this underlying pigment, these colors right here. So if we decolorize the hair or bleach the hair here and go all the way to a 10, we're gonna take out the red, the orange, and we're gonna be left with a yellow hair color. If we don't replace those tones and we take a level 10 hair and put a level 6 over it, we're gonna get the opposite color of these tones. So if you're looking at the color wheel, the opposite of red, remember we've talked about this before, is green for Christmas. So the hair is gonna be green, and not literally green. It's going to have a green or murky, muddy cast to it. And you'll notice it a lot more when you're just kind of looking out in the public world. In the public world, that sounded weird. When you're looking out in the public world, when you're looking at hair in general. A lot of times darker hair colors have that muddy green cast. And that's because when you bleached it, you took out the underlying pigment. You took out those warm tones and you didn't add them back in before you put on the darker hair color. So all a filler is doing is adding in those warm tones. Think of it as a base or protective layer. So you can then put on the darker color. So it has that pigment or that primary color to stick onto. Otherwise, it's giving you the opposite of the primary. You're getting green, you're getting ashy, blue. When you wanna use this is if you're going 3 or more levels darker. So if you're at a 10 and you want to be a level 5, that's a big gap. you're going to need a filler, something in the middle for this to hang on to. So how you even pick out a filler. And if you watched the last video, fillers, it's a lot. We can make a lot of videos on fillers. You can use temporary color, semi-permanent, demi-permanent, which is what we're gonna use today. Some people use permanent. I typically don't like to use permanent hair color if they decide to change their hair color or in 6 weeks, oh, I think I want highlights again. Really? Now you have to break through permanent, two layers of permanent hair color for the highlights. And demi-permanent is best in my opinion. Anyway, there's a lot of different ways to use fillers, a lot of products to use. We're gonna stick with demi-permanent hair color, and hopefully this is a very simplified way to do it. So Sandy has blonde hair. Sandy is a level 10. Some parts are a level 9. We're just gonna go with 10. She's here. She's brought you in an Instagram photo, Pinterest photo, whatever it be, and she says she wants to be a level 6. You're going down more than 3 levels, so you know you need a color filler. So you're gonna find a hair color that's in the middle of this gap. That's gonna be your level 8. So we're at a 10. We want to be a 6. Can you see that? Yes. So in the middle of these two, we have an 8. Then you're gonna look at the pigment chart, or the underlying pigment. We're in the yellow-orange range. You can even go a little darker, the reds, the oranges, it's okay. But that's how you're going to pick the tonality of the hair color. So the hair color we're going to use as a filler is an 8CR. An 8CR is level 8 copper red. Copper is just a nice way to say orange. So we're gonna fill our hair with these tones here. That's gonna give us a protection layer to avoid the opposite of the level 5 green here. We're going to mix this up in equal parts. So 1 ounce of color to 1 ounce of the processing solution, and I'm using the gloss to gel. So it's a little bit thicker. This is pretty similar to how you apply a toner, except the hair is dry, but in the way where you just want to get it on as quick as possible. And you can see it's a really nice orangey color. Some hints of red to replace that missing primary so we can avoid getting the opposite, which is green. And make sure you concentrate on the porous areas, which are the ends usually, making sure it's all covered. Because if you miss a spot with your filler, it's going to give you splotchy hair color at the end. So you can just comb it through just to make sure. If you're in the salon, the best place to do this would be in the shampoo bowl or the sink. It tends to get a little messy. Now, like I mentioned earlier, this doesn't have to be a demi-permanent hair color. You can use a straight primary color, a fantasy color red, semi-permanent. I used to do that a lot, honestly, because I just didn't know what else to do. And it worked, but the result was that it was too warm of a shade. If you're trying to get a neutral shade, that's not gonna cut it. That's gonna give off too much warmth. So doing something that has a level like this and a tone, level 8 with a tone of orange and red, you're gonna be able to get a more neutral color. But you can just put the fantasy color straight on the hair. The orange, the red, let it process, and then put the color on. And I forgot to mention that color fillers can also be added inside the formula. You can just mix red inside a neutral color or whatever color you're trying to put on. That's one way to do it, but it does not give the best or most predictable results, and it tends to look really warm. We're gonna let this process for 20 minutes. When you do the filler this way, you have two options. After the processing time is up, you can take a towel, a paper towel, go in and swipe this through until the hair becomes a little bit dry, taking little sections and wiping it out. And you could apply your target hair color over this. This method works, but it's more for when you're short on time. To get the best results, you wanna do what we're gonna do today, which is rinse this. You're not shampooing, you're just rinsing it with cold water. Our target level was a level 6, so we're going to use a 6N with just a little bit of 6NB. Again, with demi-permanent, you can put permanent color over this if you want. It's a 1-to-1 ratio with a processing solution. Here's the filler, the 8CR, a very coppery, fiery color. Again, I rinsed and blow dried it. Thin sections, just like we applied the last color, and we're going to apply them at the same exact time on both sides, making sure it's all covered. Especially the filler side, sometimes they can trick you because you can't really see that well. So you may need to go in with a brush if you're using a bottle just to make sure everything's covered. This is also gonna process for 20 minutes, and then I'll rinse the hair and blow dry it. Here it is after it's dry. This is the side with a filler, and this is the side without a filler. This side, you can see that obviously the color looks like a true level 5. It's neutral, but it is teetering a little bit on the warm side. So if you wanted it just a little bit cooler, you could add a dash of a cooler hair color. This side does not look like a level 5 at all, and it is very ashy. You have to get pretty close, but it's got a murky yellow greenish tone to it. And this color is just gonna keep fading and fading and fading because it doesn't have the anchor, the filler, like this side has. So that's gonna help it last longer and stay looking like a true level 5.